was ceasefire. The team came away from the meetings with what it thought was an agreement, but later found out El Salvador refused to comply with the provision calling for troop withdrawal. The Honduran army, on its part, continued patrolling its now sunken western border. There was some sporadic fighting after the ceasefire, but mainly it was a waiting game. Troops from El Salvador occupied several Honduran towns below this mountain road. El Salvador said research showed the land belonged to it in the first place. Refugees from the fighting made their way on foot through the mountains. An American missionary in Honduras, Father Zorian McFagan, tried to
help war, but I just came back through Guatemala after being captured by the Salvadorian day before yesterday. Went over there to present a petition for a ceasefire so we could bring the wounded out. But evidently it wasn't respected, and they also stole my car and took camera equipment from a Mexican newspaper man.
Did he do bodily harm to you?
No.
Did he turn you loose or something?
In a house, and they said if we left the house, they'd shoot us.
Who did you just take your ceasefire, or you went to the Salvadorian lines to ask for a ceasefire to take the wounded?
A temporary ceasefire to attend to the wounded, to bury the dead.
Can you estimate how many wounded, how many dead? In this
well, according to Father Roderick, who is still in Nuevo Gabeque, between 600 and 1,000 bodies. He couldn't count anymore after 600.
These are Honduran troops, wounded by snipers after the ceasefire supposedly was in effect.